Listen up, America. You think you're free? You think you own your own life, your home, your healthcare? Well, I've got news for you. You're living in a financial matrix, and the puppet masters pulling the strings are BlackRock, Vanguard, and State Street. These three firms are consistently among the largest shareholders in nearly all S&P 500 companies. Their influence is so widespread that it's rare to find an S&P 500 company where they do not appear in the top five shareholders. They have also turned the American dream into a lease agreement. You think you own your own home? Well, by 2030, these guys could control up to 40% of the US single-family market rentals. That's right, they're your new landlord now. Researchers have found that a small group of corporations hold a majority share in each other. It's a tightly knit web of control, and guess who's at the center? You got it. BlackRock, Vanguard, and State Street. We talk about democracy, but let's get real. These firms are the shadow government. They dictate policies that impact millions of lives, and you don't even vote for them. Take Brian Deese, for example, the guy who was the big shot at BlackRock, and now suddenly he's shaping economic policies in the Biden administration. Watchdogs or lapdogs? You tell me. You've got to understand the scale of this. BlackRock alone manages around $10 trillion. That's trillion with a T. And they're not just in finance. They're in healthcare, technology, energy, you name it. They're the largest shareholders in nearly all S&P 500 companies. It's a cartel, folks. And it's more powerful than any in human history. And don't even get me started on the media. These firms own a massive chunk of the six companies that control most of the media in the United States. So you think you're being informed or manipulated? Think about it. Ever heard of Larry Fink? This guy exploited the 2008 recession to build BlackRock's empire. He's also the same genius who popularized the toxic mortgage-backed securities that nearly tanked our economy. And now he's back to profit off the COVID-19 downturn. It's like a financial vampire that never quits. So what are the implications of this massive concentration of power in a few hands? While we live in a democracy, the concentration of corporate power in the hands of a few asset management firms creates a shadow governance structure. These firms can effectively dictate policies that impact millions, bypassing the democratic process. The Big Three's extensive ownership of six companies that control most of the media in the United States gives them a subtle but potent form of control over public opinion. This raises the question, are we being informed or manipulated? With increasing control over the housing market, these firms are turning the American dream into a lease agreement. Home ownership, a cornerstone of the middle class's stability, is becoming a luxury. Their significant stakes in the healthcare companies can also influence policies that prioritize profits over patients. The ethical dilemma, is healthcare a right or a revenue stream? You've heard of Bitcoin, right? The digital gold of the 21st century? Well, guess who's trying to hijack that freedom train? The usual suspects. BlackRock, Vanguard, and State Street are the leading players in the ETF market. ETFs are investment funds that are traded on stock exchanges similar to individual stocks. They offer a way for retail investors to invest in a variety of assets, including cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin. Here's what Robert F. Kennedy Jr. said recently, quote, "They're funneling people into these ETFs. As soon as they create a central bank digital currency, BlackRock will transform ETFs from Bitcoin into CBDCs and trap us all in that kind of slavery," unquote. So you think Bitcoin gives you anonymity? Think again. These Wall Street behemoths are scheming to replace your Bitcoin ETFs with central bank digital currencies, CBDCs for short. And let me tell you this, these CBDCs are the antithesis of anonymity. They're designed to track every penny you spend right down to your morning coffee. Imagine a world where every transaction you make is like posting a financial selfie for Uncle Sam in Wall Street to see. That's the future these firms are pushing us toward. And it gets worse. We're not just talking about loss of anonymity. We're talking about full-blown financial surveillance. Imagine a world where the government, hand in hand with these Wall Street giants, watches every financial move you make. Bought a political book they don't like? They know. Donated to a cause they're not fond of? They know. It's like George Orwell's 1984, but instead, Big Brother is watching you from a screen and he's snooping around your wallet. Now, why would firms like BlackRock, Vanguard, and State Street want this? Simple. Information is power. The more they know about your spending habits, the more they know about you, the more they can manipulate you, the market, and regulators, and ultimately the entire financial system to serve their interests, not yours. So the next time someone tells you that CBDCs are the future of finance, remember what's at stake: your freedom, your privacy, and your right to live a life free from your corporate overlords monitoring every move you make. This isn't just about money, folks. It's about preserving the very essence of individual liberty. If you found this information useful, please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in the next video.